Now we will discuss that what is the Euclid's division lemma. Basically, the Euclid's division lemma is a bit of extended form of the division algorithm. So, division algorithm is equals to dividend, dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. So, to make it more modified, what we will do, suppose we have two numbers, two positive integers A and B. Where A is greater than B, then there must exist two separate numbers, they are Q and R, such that this result R is definitely less than B but greater than or equal to 0. So we can write it like this, that A is equals to B into Q plus R, where the result R is less than B and greater than or equal to 0. This equation, this result is known as Euclid's division lemma, where you must know A and B, both are the positive integers, then there exist two separate numbers which are Q and R, where the value of R has to be mandatory less than B but more than or equal to 0. Suppose for example, if we pick any example to find the HCF, suppose we want to find the HCF of 42 and 30. Suppose one number is 42, another number is 130, we want to find their HCF using the concept of division algorithm. So if we take the division algorithm, that is a long division method, same type of process we will pursue here. Here we will say A is equals to 130, we will say B is equals to 42, and we always express with the help of this equation, it is like this, here 130 is equals to 42 into some number, 42 into 3. Then what is the remainder is coming out to be, that remainder is coming out to be 4. 130 is equal to 42 into 3 plus 4. So we will say this is A, this is B, this is Q, and this is R. So clearly the value of R is, as per condition, is more than 0 but less than B. Now we are proceeding the next division, that is the 42 is equals to. Now 42 become dividend. Now for 42, 4 will become divisor, and when this will be divided, this 10 will be the cosine, and obviously remainder has to be 2 with satisfaction of all the required conditions. Now we are coming for the next, we will take what? In our next go, we will take 4 as the dividend, 2 as the divisor, so cosine will be 2 and remainder will be 0. So the last divisor is known as the HCF, hence the HCF of 130 and 42. The HCF of 130 and 42 become 2. Now a big question comes, that if I ask you reverse of it, what is the reason that 2 is the HCF of 130 and 42? So again, there is a big problem, that yes, we can find the HCF, but reverse of it, if I ask you, that many times students are not in position to answer. It is so simple, whatever is the HCF, by the HCF, you divide both the number and you will find that the cosines are coming to be the prime number. If cosines are coming prime number, it means that that is the HCF. So in this question's case, 130 and 42 when divided by 2, we obtain the two numbers, they are 65 and 21, which are the relatively prime, hence proved that 2 is the HCF of given numbers. Now we will begin with few more fundamental theorem. Suppose there is a question, find the HCF of 225 and 135 using the Euclid's division lemma. So 225 and 135, there are the two separate positive integers. So we can always select the number which is greater as A and the smaller one as the B. So to find the HCF by using the Euclid's division lemma of two numbers, one is the 225 and other is the 135, we will say A is equals to 225 and b is equal to 135. So if we will apply this rule here, what is going to be? A is clearly 225, b is coming out to be 135, and now we can write by division algorithm or Euclid's division lemma, a is equals to b into q plus r. To convert these two numbers 225 and 135 in this form, what we will write? It is 225 is equals to 135 into such a number. When we divide it, what we get? We get 1 plus 90, because when 225 will be divided by 135, quotient will be 1 and remainder will be 90. Now for the next step, this 135 will become A and this 90 will become B. So we can write 135 is equals to 90 into 1 plus what? 45. Now, till now the remainder is not 0. In first step it was 90, in second step it is 45. So how we will go for the third step? It's again simple. We will consider 90 as the A. So 90 is equals to 45 into 2 plus 0. So it means that now remainder is coming out to be 0 and last divisor is 45. So what conclusion is coming out to be? We say the last divisor is known as the HCF. Hence you can conclude that HCF of 225 and 135 is what? 45. And for the verification, what do you know? For the verification, we know that when HCF divides these two numbers, their cosines must be prime numbers. Their cosines must be co-prime, not prime. They are relatively prime. If anything is common in their cosines, it means that number is not your. Now we will discuss with you that application of this Euclid's division lemma to solve few general results. How they can be utilized for this purpose? It's nothing. It's very simple. It's again as easy as it's the total mathematics is very easy. It's not a tough subject. It's not a dry subject. This is something what? That using the Euclid's division lemma, suppose there is any number which is greater than 4 and you are required to prove that any integer, positive integer greater than 4, any positive integer greater than 4, are you understanding? Greater than 4 can be written, can be expressed in the form of 4n plus 1 or 4n plus 3. So, division, Euclid's division lemma. Euclid's division lemma, we have two numbers, number 1 A, number 2 B. A and B are the two numbers, then there exist two other numbers. They are Q and R. R is with the condition greater than or equal to 0 and less than B. So ultimately there is a same dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Remainder can never go in the negative. So how we will say if a number is greater than 4, we can convert it in the form of 4n plus 1 or 4n plus 3 to prove the mandatory it has to be odd. So the question for you is that prove that every positive integer, if it is in the form of 4n plus 1 or 4n plus 3, it has to be odd, or you can take reciprocate. Any number greater than 4 can be expressed if it is odd in the form of 4n plus 1 and 4n plus or 4n plus 3. So here what is we are taking? A is any number greater than 4. Now I am telling you that 4 is the, A is any number greater than 4, and 4, B is what? B is equals to 4. So how we can write now? If I ask you, using the division algorithm, we can just say A is equals to 4 into Q plus R. R just can attain the values, R can be 0, R can be 1, R can be 2 or R can be 3. Because the value of B as per the Euclid's division lemma is 4, and we know that the remainder has to be greater than or equal to 0 but less than 4, which is what? 3. our purpose is to prove that if there is a number greater than 4 and if it is odd, it can be expressed out of the one form out of 2, that is either 4n plus 1 or it can be in the 4n plus 3. Okay, so we are going to tell you if we case 1, if we take r is equals to 0, so this number is going to be convert as a is equals to 4 into q plus 0, which is clearly a multiple of 2, hence it is what? It is the even number. Case 2, we are taking if r is 1, if r is 1, then a is equals to 4 into q plus 1. We know that 4 into q plus 1, that is the successive of even is the odd. So, which is what? Odd. Hence, one result is proved that if a number is in the form of 4q plus 1, it is what? Odd. We are taking the case 3. The third case is if r is equals to 2, we will say a is equals to 4 into q plus 2, which can further be written as 2 times of 2q plus 1. So, any number which is multiple of 2 is considered as what? You all know, even. Now, we are coming for the next, that is the last case, fourth case. If the value of r is 3, we say a is equals to 4 into q plus 3. So, the successor, the next to the even is what? Odd. So, this is what number? 4q plus 3 is odd. Hence, what we conclude that any number in the form of what? 4q plus 1 or 4q plus 3, it has to be a odd number. This is one thing, and in the next, that its higher application will also be discussed. Now, we are coming to take case 1, case 2, case 3, and we will find their square, and we will try to check whether the square of all these numbers are in the form of 3m plus 0 or 3m plus 1, that is 3m or 3m plus 1 or not. So, to check it, we will take first we are taking r is equals to 0, so a square is equals to 3b's whole square, so a square becomes 9b square, so a square is coming out to be 3 into 3b square, so which is clearly is of the form 3m. If I take case 2, in case 2 what is there? Case 2 has r is equals to 1. If I use this, the a is going to be 3b plus 1. If I square it, I will get a square is equals to 9b square plus 6b plus 1. A square plus b square plus 2ab. This part is the multiple of 3 and added by 1. So, what is going to become? You all know it. This is again the multiple of 3 plus 1. Hence, in first case, it was the square of number plus 0. Now, in the second case, it is the square of number plus 1. Now, I am going to take the case 3. How we will take? The case 3 is r is equal to 2. To take r is equal to 2, what we need to do? A is equal to 3m plus 2. If we go to find its square, it is coming out to be 9m square plus 12m plus 4. Again, using the same identity, a plus b whole square is equals to a square plus b square plus 2ab. I just would like to tell you here in between that what is the difference between equation and identity. Identity is true for all values, whereas equations are true for particular number of values. This is the basic difference. Now, this can also be written as 9m square plus 12m plus 3 plus 1. Here, this part is multiple of 3 added by 1. So, again we are finding it is 3m plus 1, but that is m means a number which is multiplied by m into 3 plus 1. M is what? M is any number. Now, we are going to take the last case when r is equal to 3. We will find a is equals to, we cannot take r is equals to 3 because we have taken only 3 as the divisor. So, if it is the divisors, we will take only 3 cases 0, 1 and 2, and where we are finding the squares are either in the form of the multiples of 3 or multiple of 3 increased by 1. Here you can make it very, very properly correct. So, some other uses of this Euclid's division lemma are also possible while we are solving some word problems, circular problems, type problems, and different places we can use the terminating, non-terminating, and every part of the chapter is connected to our real life. Wish you all the best for this chapter, and for more details you just can go to the further informations from this network.